Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain and today I am giving you a demo of different types of flip-flops. The order code of this equipment is 38630. Now, this is our equipment. In this, there are various NAND gates, NOT gate, a 5 volt DC supply, a pulsar as clock, and these are the QQ bar output LEDs and QMQM bar. This is the main power on off switch. We have to implement various flip flops in this equipment. Our first experiment is to construct RS flip flop and study its characteristics without clock. So make the connections as according to the circuit figure 1A. Now according to this, first give low to this point, high to this point, as you can take RNS any NAND gate. Now the output of this to the input of this, and output of this to the input of this, connect the output of R to Q. I am taking the above NAND gate as R and the below as S. The output of S to Q bar. Now these low and high state are significant as 0 and 1. High is 1, low is 0. Now according to the table given, truth table given, of, given about the SR flip-flop, we have to make given the inputs low and high and get the output Q and Q bar accordingly. So first I have given low to R and high to S. So low to R is this and high to S is this. My output should be 1 0. You can see my output is 1 0. These two LEDs will glow without any input. These are just the display LEDs. My output is this Q and Q bar. It should be 1 0. If I invert it and give low to S and high to R, which is low to S and high to R, my output should be 0 1. You can see it is 0 and 1. As you can see over here, this LED is off and this LED is on. This is 0 1. This we now take the other readings according to the table. Now the next experiment, the next flip-flop, which is to construct RS flip-flop and study its characteristics with clock. Now we have to make the RS flip-flop with clock. So with clock we have to consult with the figure 2 given in our manual. This is the figure 2A according to our manual. We have to make connections according to it. First of all, give low to S, high to R. Connect this next point of S to the clock and this point of R to also with the clock, which is a pulsar over here. Now connect the output of this NAND gate to another NAND gate input and the output of this NAND gate to another NAND gate input. Now connect the output of this NAND gate to the input of this NAND gate, as you can see, and output of this NAND gate to the input of this NAND gate. Now connect the output of S, this part, to Q. Over here I have connected. And the output of R to Q bar. This. Now initially I have given low to S, as you can see, low to S and high to R.
Now when I switch on, I have given low to S and high to R. My output is 0-1. Now if I invert it, if I invert it means I have given high to S, I have given high to S, as you can see in this table, I have given high to S and low to R. And when I give pulse, my output is 1-0, as you can see, the change. Like this, take all the readings by adjusting the value of S and R input, low or high. Give both as low, give both as high, and take the desired output to on Q and Q bar. That's it in the second experiment. Now we move on to the third experiment, which is to construct D flip-flops and study its characteristics. Now we have to construct D flip-flop to study its characteristics. Before this, let me get ready for the connections. Now for the experiment 3, the connections are, we have to consult to figure 3A. These are the connections for experiment 3D flip-flop. Now let me make the connections. First give low to a NAND gate. Connect this same low and give it to NOT gate. The output of NOT gate, give it to another NAND gate. Now we will connect a clock common to both the NAND gates, to both the inputs of NAND gate 1. Like this, I have given clock to both. Now the output of this NAND gate is connected to another NAND gate. The output of this NAND gate is connected to this. The output of the another NAND gate is connected to the lower one input of NAND gate. And this output, as you can see, is connected to the input of the above NAND gate. And now the output of our above NAND gate is connected to Q. And the output of below NAND gate is connected to Q bar. Now initially I have given low to D input. As I switch on, when I have given low to D, as you can see in this, as I give my pulse clock, as I give my clock pulse, my output is on Q and Q bar is 0-1. As you can see on the LED display, it is 0 and 1. Now when I give high to my input, input D, and as I give the clock pulse, my input will change. It is 1-0. You can see over here. This is the function of the D flip-flop, and you can calculate the other readings according to the table given in our manual, as you can see. Now we move on to the next experiment. The next experiment is to construct JK flip-flop and study its characteristics. Now we have to construct a JK flip-flop. Let me get ready for the connections. Now the JK flip-flop. Now this is the circuit for our JK flip-flop. This one, figure 4. Which is the object over here, we can see, to construct JK flip-flop and study its characteristics. This is the circuit over here. Now I will make the connections according to this. Connect low to the input of one NAND gate, high to the input of this NAND gate. Connect this to clock. And this also to clock. Now connect the output of this for the JK flip-flop, we have to use a 3-input NAND gate. I've done this mistake. For JK flip-flop, we have to use a 3-input NAND gate. You can see in the circuit, it is a 3-input NAND gate. So, for this, first connect low to the first input, high to this lower part. Connect clock with the middle point of 3-input NAND gate. Now, connect the third input of this NAND gate to the input of another NAND gate and to the output of this NAND gate. Similarly, connect this input to the input of this NAND gate and output of this NAND gate, as you can see in the circuit. Now connect the output of this NAND gate directly to the input of this NAND gate and this output to this input. Now we have to connect this point as preset, this point as clear of the lower NAND gate, this point as clear to the high level supply, and this point as preset also to the high level supply. And now we connect the output of the above NAND gate as J to Q, as you can see over here. And the output of this NAND gate to Q bar, means the lower NAND gate K to Q bar, as you can see. Now, as I switch on, initially, according to the table, I have given 0 to J and 1 to K. I have given 0 to J and 1 to K. If we see in the table, 0 to J and 1 to K, the output should be 0 and 1. As you can see over here, it is 0 and it is 1. If I reverse it, now I have given 1 to K, sorry, 1 to J and 0 to K. As I give the clock pulse, my output will be 1 0. As you can see in this table, my output will be 1 0. Similarly, take all the readings according to the table given in the manual and perform this experiment and you will get the desired results. Now the experiment 5, to construct T flip-flop and study its characteristics. Now for this, we have to see figure 5 in our manual. This is the figure 5, according which we have to make the connections. Now for this, first we will take 3 input NAND gate, in which the middle point, short both the points and connect it to high. Now give clock to these two points. Give clock to these two points. Now connect this point of NAND gate to the input of this two input NAND gate and to the output of the below NAND gate, and this output to be connected to Q bar. Please consult the manual while you are making the while you make the connections. This 3 input NAND gate connected to this 2 input NAND gate and this 2 input NAND gate connected to Q. First connect it to the output of this 2 input NAND gate and then this output is connected to Q. Now the output of this 3 input NAND gate goes to the input of this 3 input NAND gate and the output of this 3 input NAND gate goes into the input of this 3 input NAND gate. This is connected to the output of this and this point is connected to the output of this. This output is connected to the input of NAND gate and this output is also connected to QM. This output is connected to QM bar. and it is also connected to the input of this NAND gate, two input, and these two NAND inputs, these two inputs are short. These two inputs are short and connected, these two inputs and connected to the this point of NOT gate, and the input of NOT gate is connected to the clock NOT gate. Input of NOT gate is connected to the clock. Now this input of this NAND gate, 3 input, is connected to high, and this input of this 3 input NAND gate is also connected to high as preset, and the lower one which is connected to high as clear. Now we have made the connections. As you can see, the connections are very tedious, so please consult the manual while connecting through the equipment. Now as I switch on, as it is a T flip-flop, the output state will toggle when I give my clock pulse. Now first, after connecting this, this output is connected to this, and this output is connected to this last two input NAND gate, and now my connections are complete according to my figure. Now as I switch on, this is my output. Now when I use the pulse clock generator, my output will toggle. As it is a T flip-flop, you can see when I give my clock pulse over here, as I give my clock pulse, my output will toggle. As you can see, when I give my clock pulse, my output will toggle. As you can see, from this point, and now when I am giving clock pulse to this point, my output is toggling. This is the working of the experiment T flip-flop. Now, the last experiment is, to construct master-slave JK flip-flop and study its characteristics. Now, before this, let me get ready for the connections. Now this is our last experiment. Experiment 6, JK Master Slave Flip Flop. For this we have to see figure 6A and make the connections according to it. Now for this, first I give Now first I give low to this 3 input NAND gate, middle point, and high to this below 3 input NAND gate, middle point. Short these two points and connect it to clock. Pulsar here. Through this point, connect it to input of NOT gate, and this output of NOT gate is connected to this. First, short this two input NAND gate, and the output of this NOT gate is connected to this. Now, connect this point input to the input of this NAND gate and this point to the output of this NAND gate, and through this output connect it to Q. Now similarly, this 3 input NAND gate is connected to this point of 2 input NAND gate, and its input of this is given to the output of this 2 input NAND gate, and the output from this two input NAND gate is given to Q bar. Now the output of this first 3 input NAND gate is given to the input of second 3 input NAND gate, and this output is given to this input. As you can see, this point is connected to the output of this point, and this point is connected to the output of this point. Through the output of this second 3 input NAND gate, it is connected to QM over here, and this output is connected to QM bar over here. Now the same QM bar 1 point is connected to the input of this 2 input NAND gate, and this QM point is connected to this 2 input NAND gate. The output of this point is connected to this point, and this point is connected to this point. And what another thing we have to do, we have to connect this point and this point and connect both to high. The lower one works as clear and the above point works as preset. Now as we switch on our circuit and give the clock pulse, I have given low to J and high to K. My output will be displayed in the LEDs. According to this, vary the different inputs, low and high, in J and K, and get the desired output on these LEDs. This is a function of the JK master slave flip-flop. All these experiments need lab manual as the circuits are very difficult to perform. So for any further information, please consult the lab manual. Thank you.